Hi, I'm Dr. Darcy Snowden, and today I'm going to show you guys how to use your LIGO color sensor to measure the red, green, and blue values detected by the sensor and make a plot of them in the LIGO Spike app. This is helpful for Mission Objective 5 and Lesson 5, which is roving under the moon. In order to do this, you'll need your LIGO sensor, your LIGO Spike robot, and I'm going to, just for as an example, use this worksheet from the companion course lesson. Here we are in the LIGO Spike app. I'm connected to my robot, but I haven't yet plugged in my color sensor. I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and I'm plugging it into port B. Once I do that, you can see that I can see my color sensor. On port B, I can put it over some different colors. And if it's a known color, you can see that I have detected it with my color sensor. That's normally how the color sensor works. You're looking for specific colors like red, green, blue, cyan, and magenta. But in this lesson, we're going to show you how to use it as a more basic sensor to give numerical values that will tell you about the colors that's being detected. In order to do what I'm asking you to do, you're going to have to add some more features to the LIGO Spike app. In order to do that, you can go down to the lower left-hand part of the window. And if you hover over these icons here, it says Show Block Extensions. When you click on that, you've got some basically additional code blocks you can add to the Spike app. And you can see there's lots of options here. In order to do what we're trying to do today, you want to add the more sensors one here and the line graph here. And what that does is now if I look on the left-hand panel here that shows all the code blocks available, I've got two more sets that I can use in my program associated with those extensions. Okay, so what I'm going to try to do now is I'm going to set up my robot to measure and plot the red, green, and blue values on the worksheet that I showed you before. So in order to do that, I need to write a program that tells the robot to make a measurement at some specific time interval and then make the plot. So I'm going to use, again, some of the older code blocks and the new ones in order to do that. There's probably different ways to do this. The way that I'm going to do it is I'm going to use this repeat block. Everything inside of this block here is going to get repeated. It defaults to 10 times, but I'm going to up this quite a bit just so we don't run out of measurements when I'm doing the demo here. So this code inside that I put inside here is going to repeat 1,000 times. And then what I want to do is I want to make a plot on a line graph. So it can be useful if you like at the beginning of the program to add this block, which is just to clear old data from an established line graph. So I'm going to add that at the top. And then I want to make a plot. So I'm going to grab this one. And basically what this block does is it plots what's ever being measured here. So right now it's just defaulting to zero. And then this is specifying the color of the line. In this case, what I want to plot is the red value being measured by my color sensor. So in the more sensors code blocks here, I can pull down this code block that says raw red, okay? And it should insert in there. Okay, so now it's gonna plot the value measured by my color sensor, the raw red value, and it makes more sense to me to make that a red line. And I can plot more than one thing. I can plot as many things as I want. So I'm going to go ahead and plot all of our primary colors, red, green, and blue. Okay, the last thing that I need to do is just give it some indication or maybe a delay here so that I'm only making measurements every certain amount of time. So I'm going to go to my control and I'm going to add a weight in here so it's not making continuous measurements. I think you can do that if you like, but I will go ahead and make measurements, we'll say every 0.2 seconds. Okay, so now looking at this program, the first thing that's gonna happen is it will clear any established line graph, and then it'll repeat these four blocks every 0.2 seconds 1,000 times. So it'll be plotting what's measured by my color sensor in the raw red value to a red line, the raw green values to a green line, and the raw blue value, forgot to change that, to a blue line. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put the color sensor over these individual colors and I'll show you what that looks like in the panel plot. So what I need to do is open up the plotting panel. I can do that by clicking on this icon down here, and I can even make it large so it fills the whole screen. You see here, this is the line graph that's going to be plotted. I can also look at the data in a tabular form, and then I can still start the program from this screen. So I'm going to go ahead again and start the program, and then I'll go and move my color sensor over these different colors. Okay, so now it's over red, green, blue. Again, you can see some of the darker colors, you're actually getting less reflected light. So that's an interesting lesson for the students. This is yellow, so that's an interesting one. Cyan, magenta, orange. Okay, so this is just a different, more quantitative way to detect colors. I'll go ahead and stop the program. Again, now I've got a graph of the colors detected, but I can also look at the values in a tabular form. And if I go down here, I can also export the data if I want to plot it in another program. The last thing I'd like to remind you guys of is in the companion course lesson 5, which is associated with the mission objective, there are some additional resources, including these slides, that you can use to help students learn about the RGB color scale and color mixing in general. So these are a resource for you to help students understand how the quantitative or number values they're getting from their color sensor relates to the color being measured by the robot. And there's even some help provided with adding those extensions and writing the program. Good luck, and don't forget to reach out if you need any help.